Hi and welcome to another Bitwig episode. Today we're going to take a look at the Polysynth device of the Bitwig. Let's take the tour. Okay, this is a clean project in the Bitwig studio. And in Bitwig you work with the devices. So to add a new instrument, you can either right-click this track area and select Add Instrument Track, or you can also press Command-T to add a track. And when we have added this new track, you have this area down here for this instrument, and you have a plus sign where you can add the devices. And if you press the plus sign, you will open up this browser window, which is an excellent place to find the specific devices or presets or samples that you are looking for in your project. You see, you can preview samples and you can also select your devices. I highly suggest that you categorize your devices like I have done here. You can see that I have a few collections here. It's called collections. I would like to call them folders, but in Bitwig you call them collections. To create a collection, you right-click this favorites area and create new collection. And then you can name this to My Synths or whatever. And then you just find the specific synth you're after, maybe the Diva synth, and you drag it to this My Synths collection. And now it's very easy. The next time you want to add an instrument, we just go to the plus sign, My Synths, and boom, you have the Diva available. So that's how you categorize your instrument and devices to easily find them. Let's remove that and go to Synths and find our Polysynth. The Polysynth is one of the synthesizers within Bitwig, and this is the initialized preset. To play, to use your computer keyboard as a MIDI keyboard, you can press the caps lock key, which activates the MIDI keyboard mode. And now if I press an A on the keyboard, I get a C, and the S will be a D, and the D will be an E. And then C sharp, W, and D sharp is the E key. So now you know how to insert and play the keyboard if you don't have a MIDI keyboard available. Okay, so let's first add some notes so we have something to work with while we are exploring the Polysynth. And I can press Shift and Tab to open up a full view of the piano roll. And just insert a few notes. Let's actually remove that, and now we can just loop this by holding at the right downside of this event, and now we can drag it out and it will make a loop. If we drag the upper side, we will just extend the clip like this. So drag at the bottom right corner and you will have a loop. And if we want to make changes to this part, this second part of the loop, we can consolidate this MIDI clip by pressing Command and J. And now this is a full MIDI clip, so we can make changes to the second part of this little loop. and set your sequencer to loop mode. Okay, let's go back to the device. You need to depress the caps lock key in order to get back to a mode where you can press the keys to open up different windows. Okay, now we're back at the Polysynth and we can change the shape. If it's set to the middle, it's going to be a sawtooth. And if we drag it all to the left, it will be a square wave. And if we drag it further to the right, it will be a sawtooth, but at double the rate. So it will be a higher pitch. So that's the basic waveforms that you have available in the Polysynth. And you have two oscillators in the Polysynth. We have this first oscillator, and we have a second oscillator. Then we go into a oscillator mix panel, where we can choose how we will mix the different oscillators. And they can be mixed in various ways, either just by maybe having 50% of each oscillator, like this. Let's make this into a sawtooth again. You can see here I can change the octave of each oscillator. And then we can also make unison to get more voices and a bigger, fatter sound. So if we have this set to sawtooth and press the voices and drag it up to maybe four voices, you can see here that we get a bigger sound. And they are quite spread. Here you control the unison spread. So now we can hear it phase. And if we increase the spread, you can really go far out with this. And you can also control the stereo spread of these voices. So now they are all mono, but at different detuned pitches for the four voices. Then after the oscillator mix, we have the filter section. And you also have directly available a filter envelope and a amplitude envelope. And then we go into the note section, where we can add arpeggiators and note shifting or note pitch shifting devices if we want. And we have a effect section to add effects to this Polysynth device. Then you can control the panning of the device. And you have the amp velocity, how this device will behave to velocity from the keyboard. And then you have a gain section and a output volume section. So at the beginning, the filter is set to around 2.5K. So we can control this manually, or we can let the envelope, the filter envelope, control the amplitude, the filter. So if we drag down the decay, we can hear a sharper envelope for the filter. And we can also control the slope of the filter. So maybe we want it to be even faster or more tight. You can hear here, if you drag this upwards, the curve upwards to 0.5, we will have a bit of a sloppy filter envelope. And if we drag it around, you have a tighter, sharper envelope. And this is the resonance of the filter. So if we want to do a kind of acid bass, we can drag the filter down, increase the filter resonance, so we get that TB303 sound. And then in the filter section, we will actually add the spectrum analyzer, so we can see the sound that we are creating now. And we can also you can see that the filter is controlled by key tracking now, so that the filter will follow the keys on the keyboard. So if you play higher up, the filter will open up slightly more. And we can control the amount of filter tracking, key tracking. Let's hear that with one voice. 12 voices. Maybe 4 voices can be enough for now. Okay, how to breathe a little bit more life into this acid-based patch? Well, we can maybe make the resonance move around a little bit, or maybe the filter frequency a little bit. Maybe that would be fun to do, so let's go here to the modulators section of our Polysynth, and we can add maybe the random device, which will generate a random number. And now we can press this dot and arrow and make it move the filter envelope depth of this filter envelope. And now we can also see that it affects this envelope depth. And we can also control the amount. Let's make it control the resonance a little bit too. Maybe add a little bit of drive before our oscillator signal goes into the filter. Add a little drive here before. We will also add a little peak limiter here, so we don't go overboard with the volume. We can also introduce some glide to this, so that the notes will glide into each other. Not too much glide in this sound, maybe. And then this filter also have a few different wave shaping settings. You can set it to a soft clip, sine wave shaping, and also hysteresis, which is more drastic overdrive / wave shaping filters. Let's select the hysteresis and see what happens to the sound. A little bit of delay to make the sound a little bit more fun. So you can really add some grittiness to your Polysynth sounds with this filter effect. And select the rectifier. Now we have a very bubbly sound. A very cool thing with the delay is to add another effect in the feedback section of the delay. I usually add either a frequency shifter or I add some other kind of panning maybe, or overdrive, which we can do with the distortion. Now we have only the oscillator 2, which is the square wave. You can also add sub. That means you gradually move this square wave 1 octave down. And here you can control the sync or the pulse width. So let's make a little LFO, add a LFO modulator and press the dot and arrow and make it modulate the sync and drag down the hertz value, the rate, so it's not so fast, and maybe the amount, drag down the amount a little bit so it don't move, so it doesn't move around too much. Okay, so let's reset this device and add the polysynth again, and maybe we can create some kind of bass sound. More like a regular bass. So let's go into a square wave. Change the shape into a square wave. Move it down an octave. And add maybe two voices. And mix in the second oscillator and make it even lower. And let the lower octave be one voice and the upper, which is an octave higher, be two voices or maybe four voices. And decrease the spread a little bit. And mix these two together. If you want the bass to be more mono, just drag down the filter, the unison depth. So let's add a little kick to this. Press this plus sign and maybe we can select the drum. The electric kick of Bitwig, which is a device to generate a kick. Let's go in here and double click and add a MIDI event. and add a 4 to the floor kick. And make this loop for the whole section. Now, if we want to sidechain, we can just add the tool device to our bass and insert the audio sidechain bus and select the group electric kick as input. Drag down the release. Yeah, so that's how you create some sounds with a Polysynth. I hope you like this tutorial, and please shoot me any comments and questions if you have any on the Polysynth device. I'll make another video on the FM4 and the organ and the other devices of Bitwig. If you're new here, please subscribe and be sure to check out my previous videos. Until next time, see you soon. Bye bye.